In natural systems, it's very rare to see a soil uncovered. Soils are covered by a canopy and sometimes also by a layer of residue or duff. This cover, whether canopy or the residue or duff, protects the soil in terms of it keeps it cool in the summer and a little bit warmer in the winter, and it also provides protection from impact of raindrop and therefore reduces erosion. A covered soil is also a fed soil. Plants feed the soils, feed the soil microbes through root exudates. These are mainly carbohydrates that they get through photosynthesis. And a duff layer or a residue layer feeds the soil microbes through decomposition. If you don't believe me, go to a place where some leaves have been left for a year or two and look underneath that leaf cover. It's absolutely amazing. Now, there are times where natural systems are uncovered for a while, maybe through a disturbance event like a flood or a fire. But very soon, the first thing that you're going to see is the growth of little plants, and usually these are weeds. Mother Nature does not like to be uncovered, and so she uses weeds to cover her wounds. Ray Archuleta likes to say that weeds are the ambulance workers or the scabs of the land, and I agree with them. The best way to stimulate weed production is through tillage. Now, in my 1,000-square-foot garden, it's pretty easy for me to get cover on. If I don't have some kind of a cover crop, I usually make use of a straw mulch, or more recently, I grind up leaves and I put them over the area that might be uncovered. At City Roots, Eric and Robbie make use of cover crops. They use them as smother crops. These cover crops will grow up and tend to outcompete anything that's there, and when it's rolled down, it forms a thick mat that smothers out any other weeds, at least for the first 6 to 8 weeks. Because they don't have the convenience of herbicides, Eric and Robbie tend to use single species cover crops so that they can figure out when best to terminate them. The last thing you want is a multi-species cover crops with different termination dates, because that is going to, the part that's not terminated may become a competitor to some of your cash crops. So you have to be careful if you're not using herbicides. In row cropping systems like the one Jason has, a straight no-tilling system will allow the residue from the previous year's crop to build up. Now, because Jason also makes use of multi-species cover crops, he can grow up to about 10,000 pounds per acre of biomass, which he rolls down just before planting. This usually forms a huge mat, apart from the fact that it has outcompeted any plants in the spring. It forms a huge mat, and what Jason has found is he can plant into it with a good sharp coulter, and what he's found is that he uses very little herbicide after that to deal with weeds. In addition to the mat keeping weeds at bay, the mat also keeps his soils cool, probably between 20 and 30 degrees between soils that are covered and uncovered. This picture over here was taken on Jason's farm on May the 31st, 2 years ago, and it's very clear where the soils are covered and uncovered. Finally, the mat that Jason has serves as a real barrier to any sort of raindrop impact, and we simply do not see any erosion off Jason's farm, whereas his neighbor, who is a conventional tiller, loses a great deal of soil, and it actually lands up in some of Jason's fields. So the bottom line here is that a reduction in tillage and the use of mulches and cover crops will armor the soil and keep that soil biology functioning. Oh yes, and you may ask whether I have any special implements to roll down my cover crop. Well, I do have something, and it's called a 6x6. It's very high tech, and I'd like you to look at this little clip. Enjoy.